Okay, so good morning, everybody. Welcome to lecture 16, quantum mechanics part 1. So in the last lecture, I had asked you all to solve some problems from Sakurai, exercises 1.6, 1.7a, 1.8, and 1.10. So let me talk about exercise number 1.7a from Sakurai. Okay, and so this question is that you have some Hermitian operator. A, and it has some set of eigenvalues. A prime, right? And this is the set of eigenvalues, and the set of eigensets or eigenvector are, right? We'll just put a ket, eigenkets, right? And there is no degeneracy, right? So no two eigenvalues, no two eigenstates have the same eigenvalues, right? And then the question is that prove that so this is an operator, right? This is an operator. Prove that this operator is null. Okay, so what does this mean when you say that an operator is null? So if an operator is null, that means when I act with the operator on any Vishnu, do you have a question? If you have a, otherwise
yes, sir.
You can look. Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, in that question, the product of A minus A bar, this that A bar is just an eigenvalue or it's acting with an identity operator?
Yeah, of course. It's understood that there is an identity operator here. Right? Otherwise, you can't subtract these two things. Huh? Okay? Otherwise, you can't subtract this from this, right? Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, we say an operator is null if the action of this operator on all states of the system is zero. For all states in the Hilbert space, then we say that O is a null operator, right? So it annihilates all the every state, right? So how do you show that this is null? Does anybody have an idea? Any ideas? Yes. Okay, so let's start. First of all, what is the property of a Hermitian operator? Right, there's a completeness property, right? That any state of the system can be written as a superposition of eigenstates, right? So this is a sum over all the eigenstates. These are the eigenstates of the operator. And then this is the coefficient of this state, right? In that basis. Okay. Now, so what you want to show is that if you take P and act on psi, this should be equal to zero, right? There's no hat, this is just a number. So what we want to do is we want to take this operator and act on psi, right? So we replace, instead of psi, we write psi in terms of its expansion in terms of, right? And I have to use different indices because A, the index A is already used here. So here I have to use some index A prime, right? Okay, so now can you see what is going on? Will this, can you see the fact that this will be null? See, if you look at this operator P, what is this operator? This is, you can write it like this, right? It's the product of all the eigenvalue, all the, right? Let's say there are n, if it's an n-dimensional Hilbert space, there'll be n eigenvalues, n eigenvectors. So this will be the operator, right? Now, if you take any one of the terms in this expression, right, for some I, and you act on the corresponding eigenstate, what does that give you? Vishnu, what will you get?
No, sir. So if A operator acts, it will give the eigenvalue and that state.
What will be the result of this? What will you get over here?
So it's A minus AA.
Which is what?
Which is zero, sir, but I'm confused how that AI acts on the eigenstate.
This is AI acting on this will go give you AI.
That's okay, sir. But the next term minus AI acting.
Next one is identity, right? It's just a number.
Okay. Oh, sir, okay. It's okay. Clear, sir.
It's clear now. Now you know what's going on.
Is AI the eigenvalues?
So AI is one of the eigenvalues, right? You take any one of the terms in this expression.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, yes, sir, yes.
So in this expression, you go term by term in this sum. You pick the first term. One of the terms from this product will annihilate that term. Right? So you pick A1. So then this one will annihilate A1. You pick A2. This one will annihilate A2.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, I'm going.
Sir, is it exactly like we are finding the eigenvalues of a matrix with the equation A minus lambda, determinant of A minus lambda equal to zero?
Yeah, but there is no determinant. I'm not taking any determinant. Huh?
Okay.
Right? And also, I'm not taking any determinant. That's the first thing. And then the second thing is, so this is not the same thing. Okay. All right, then what other problems did I ask you? 1.8 and 1.10. So those of you who attempted it, were you able to do 1.8 and 1.10? Let's see, what is 1.8? So use the orthonormality of plus state and minus state. Right, so what is a plus state? The up, down by root 2, and then the minus state is up, down, right? And these states are orthogonal, right? You can, that's easy enough to show, I think. So So what you have to do is you have to prove the following, that if you take the commutator of Si and Sj, right, where Si and Sj are given in the next, I'll define them in a minute. This is the commutator of Si and Sj, and this, the second object, is the anti-commutator of Sn. So anti-commutator is just with a plus sign. Okay. So we have to prove this, given that what are Si and Sj? So you have Sx, so I, J, K go from, they take values in X, Y, and Z. Okay, so let me first write out this, these expressions, and then I will go over what they mean. Okay, so now in the last class, remember that I when we were talking about completeness and projection operators and so on, I explained to you that if you take an object of this form, right, which is called the outer product of two states, this object is an operator, right? It's a matrix and it behaves like an operator, right? So you can do this for any vector space, whether real or complex, it doesn't matter, right? So if you look at these expressions here, these expressions are contain these terms, right? Plus, minus, minus, plus, so on. Ketpra. So these are operators, right? So before we go into the how to solve this, let me just show you the different possible representations of how to write an operator. So for instance, if you have the Pauli matrix, right? The Pauli matrix is the Z, sigma Z is 1, 0, 0, minus 1, right? Are you all there? Can you hear me? Like, I don't know if you can hear me or not.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay. Yes, sir. So this is sigma Z, right? And what are the eigenstates? The eigenstates are the up state, right, which is 1, 0, and the down state, which is 0, 1, right? These are the two eigenstates. So given any operator, if I have any operator and I have some set of eigenstates, I can write down the matrix representation of that operator, right? So the matrix representation is found by taking this inner product of the operator sandwiched between the ith eigenstate and the jth eigenstate. Okay. So for instance, if I have a two-dimensional Hilbert space, right? So if my Hilbert space is two-dimensional, right, then what will be the matrix representation of any operator? You will get that you can represent it like this, right? A11, A12, A21, and A22, where A11 is what? A12 is, right? So these objects, these numbers, right? How do we get these numbers? We take these numbers by evaluating this operator in the given basis. So if you look at this, if you look at this expression over here, right, for sigma z, then what you can see is that sigma z, it's there are only two non-zero terms. The first is this one, and the second is this one. Right? This will give you one in this diagonal term and minus one here, right? Okay. Can you please raise your hands if you are able to follow what I'm doing here? If you, okay, so about half the class at least is able to follow what I'm doing. Okay, that's fine. You can lower your hands now. Thanks. So those of you who don't understand what I'm doing, like Rahul. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Rahul, you didn't raise your hand, no?
Yes, sir, I have raised my hand.
Oh, you raised your hand. Hey, matlab, are you able to follow or not?
Yes, sir, I am able to follow.
Pritam?
Yes, sir.
Pritam, are you there?
Hello.
But yes, sir. Yeah, can you tell me if you have any difficulties?
No, sir.
Hmm?
No, sir. Not.
I see. There is any difficulty? Tell me. I will go over the concept again slowly. Tanmay. Tanmay, are you? Aap hai wahan pe? Tanmay. Hello, Tanmay, can you say something in the chat?
Hello, yes, sir.
Can you respond when I'm asking a question, Tanmay?
I was lost connection for something.
Lost connection, acha. So, Tanmay, are you able to follow what I'm doing?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sadanand?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to follow what I have done here?
Yes, sir, but I can't hear properly, sir, because of network problem, sir. So
network problem.
Not problem, sir.
Okay, okay. All right. Fine, fair enough. Okay. All right. So now these are the matrix elements, right? So there is another way to write down this operator. What is that way? So let's look at again. We'll look at this example and we'll look at all the different Ketbra combinations that we can make out of these operators. Okay. And for simplicity, I'm going to label this as the zero state, and this as the one state. Okay. So let's look at all the possible combinations that one can have. You can have 0, 0, right? What is 0, 0 now? 0, 0 is 1, 0, 1, 0, right? What will be the result of this? You'll get 1, 0, 0, 0 like that, right? So this is the corresponds to this matrix. Okay, what is 0, 1? 1, 0, 0, 1. right? So if you work it out, you'll get 0, 1, 0, 0 like this. This will give you 1, right? So from this, I hope that it's clear what this element corresponds to, right? This element this corresponds to a matrix. Let me call this matrix O, where Oij is equal to 1 and rest are 0. Right? Now, if you look at these matrices and I ask you to write down this operator, sigma z, what is sigma z? Sigma z I can write like this, 1, 0, 0, 0, plus 0, 0, 0, minus 1 like this, right? So in terms of these matrices, how can I write it? This first term, I can write as ket 0, bra 0. And the second term I can write minus ket 1, bra 1. Yes, I can do that or not?
Yes, sir.
I'm just taking a sum of matrices, no? So this is my representation of sigma 1, one of the representations. So all of these representations are equivalent, right? Whether I give the individual matrix element or whether I write it in this form. Okay. So in general, if I want to write down for any operator, if I want to write the operator in this form, how will I do that? I can do it like this, right? It will be some combination of these ij, these ket I bra j, right? So these are my basis matrices. Right? These are my basis matrices, meaning that I can represent any matrix as a linear combination of these basis elements. And then what are the coefficients? The coefficients are this Aij. Right? So in particular for sigma z, what would I say? I would say sigma z, 0, I will have 1, 1 is equal to 1, and sigma z, 2, 2 is equal to minus 1, and the rest are all 0, right? Okay. So that is what is happening over here. That is what this expression represents. Sx, Sy, and Sz. Right? So if you look at Sx, for example, and okay. And now we are given, we have this statement that sigma plus and sigma minus are orthogonal to each other. Sigma plus and sigma minus are orthogonal. So I can always take sigma plus to be 1, 0, and sigma minus to be 0, 1, right? These two are orthogonal to each other, right? Now you might argue that, well, I can't do this because I've already said that the up state or the zero state is 1, 0. So why can I write it as sigma plus when I know that this sigma plus, when I know that sigma plus is actually equal to this 0 plus 1, right? So the thing is that here, what I'm doing is I'm working in a basis. I've changed my basis, right? I'm no longer in this basis. I have changed my basis to one in which these vectors are my basis vectors. Okay. So if you work with this basis, what will you get for the up and down state? Right. So if you want to get the up and down state, what you have to do is you have to just invert this linear relationship. Right. And if I'm not mistaken, there's one mistake that this should be. Is that right? 1 second. Root 2. I think that's right. So if you add and subtract these two guys, right, what you will get is that sigma plus ket up is equal to sigma plus sigma minus by root 2, right? And what is that in terms of these two guys? It's going to be 1, 1. And then sigma, similarly, ket down is going to be sigma plus sigma minus by root 2, which is 1 by root 2 times 1 minus 1. Right? So this is a change of basis. That's all I've done. Now, if you ask what are the components of Fx, if I am told that Fx is given by this expression, right, in this basis, as a matrix, immediately I can read off the matrix elements, right? Plus, minus, minus, plus, these are the off-diagonal elements. So I get this expression for F of x, right? Similarly, for sy, what do I get? Sy becomes ih bar by 2 minus plus. So I get 1 here, I get minus 1 here, I get 0. And similarly, this guy becomes h bar by 2, 1, 0, 0, minus 1. Right? Because plus plus and minus minus, and there's a negative sign, so I get 1 and minus 1. Okay, now this form of writing operators is very important, especially, for instance, when you study quantum computation, and also when you do many body physics. So anything to do with electrons and protons, or tight binding models, and so on. So now the question asks, prove that this expression is true. So this expression is here, right? Now I have to evaluate, let's see, one of these expressions. So let me evaluate this Fx, Sy, right? So what is Fx, Sy? It's equal to this. Now, once I have this matrix representation, I can already see that that these are just the Pauli matrices. So if I take the Pauli matrices, I know that the Pauli matrices satisfy this commutation relation, right? So I'm done. But if you want to be a little bit more careful about it, right? So let's say we did not already know that these matrices satisfy this relationship. How would we proceed? So now I have Fx is this guy, Sy is this. Okay. So let me calculate the terms in this expression one by one. So what is Fx times Sy, right? It will give you I h bar square by 4, right? The product of this and this. And now when I look at these terms, right, you get the product of this term and this term. What is that going to be? That is going to be plus minus minus plus, right? And let me be a little extra careful. I'll get terms like this, right? Now, if you look at this term, what does this simplify to? Can somebody tell me? Sonali. Sonali, can you tell me what this will be equal to? So if I give you this, what is this going to be equal to? Sonali?
Hello? Square plus.
Huh? Bolo.
Can you hear me, sir?
Huh? Okay, fine. Sukhmanpreet, can you tell me what this will be equal to?
No idea, sir.
No idea. Okay, so let's go step by step. You have this expression in the middle, no? Right, Sukhmanpreet?
Yes, sir.
So what is this expression equal to?
This is 1.
Right. Theek hai na? So then what are you left with in the remaining expression? Sukhmanpreet? What is left? You are simplifying this, na? So this part becomes 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Hai na? So kya bachta hai bataiye? Left side pe kya bachega? Agar aapke paas a b c hai aur aapka b 1 hai, to aapke paas kya bachta hai?
AC.
हाँ, तो इसमें से क्या बचता है बताइए?
Cat's eye and brass eye.
ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
तो इस expression में से क्या बचेगा? Right? Sukhmanpreet?
Yeah, sir. Cat plus bra plus.
Bra, right? ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, we have the other terms. What are the other terms? Let's see. Let's take this guy and this guy. ठीक है, नाउ अनन्या, हाउ विल आई प्रोसीड?
यस सर.
हाउ विल आई प्रोसीड?
दैट द मिडिल टर्म
हाँ
प्लस कैट एंड ब्रा विल बी 0 बिकॉज़ ऑर्थोगोनल.
एक्जेक्टली.
सो द होल
विल बी 0, राइट? So in this way, you multiply out these various terms and what you will find is that fxsy, you will get ih bar squared by 4, right? From this term and from this term, you will get plus plus. And from this term and from this term, you will get minus minus. Okay, now I can write this as ih bar and then 1 second. Right, I can write this as ih bar by 2 multiplied by h bar by 2 and this expression, right? And what is this expression? We can see that this expression is equal to S of Z. Right? So what do I get? I get I h bar by 2 S of Z, right? That is Sx, Sy. So if you work out the same thing for Sy, Sz, what will you get? You will get minus I h bar Sz by 2. So if you take the difference of these two terms, which is the commutator, you will get I h bar S of Z, right? So in this expression, what is this epsilon ijk? I've explained this to you, I think, before. Shubham, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So what is this epsilon ijk?
One. Sir, one equal to one.
It's equal to one for all values of ijk?
No, sir.
Then?
Sir, cyclic, if cyclic, so one.
Ijk are not different, right? Ijk are... I have not specified what ijk are, right? मैंने बताया आपको ijk क्या है?
नहीं सर.
ये अभी बस indices है ना ijk?
Yes sir.
अगर मैं आपको specific values देता हूँ, epsilon 1, 2, 3, ये क्या है?
Zero. Zero sir.
Ashwini.
Yes, sir.
ये क्या है? What is epsilon 1, 2, 3?
One.
अच्छा. और what is epsilon 1, 3, 2?
Minus 1.
And what is epsilon 1, 1, 2?
0.
0. Shubham?
Yes, sir.
आप समझ रहे हैं?
Yes, sir.
Right. So it is equal to one when this is a cyclic permutation. It is equal to minus one when it is when it is an even permutation. It is equal to one when it is equal to an odd permutation. It is equal to minus one. Otherwise, it's equal to zero. Okay. So what is, if I write down Sx, comma Sy, if I look at this expression, h bar by 2, epsilon xyz, S of Z. So what is the meaning of this expression? In this expression, I am actually summing over k. Here k is the repeated index. Na? And it's easy to get confused, but this is I, which is square root of minus 1. Epsilon ijk. H bar SK. So I'm summing over this K index. Okay. So here let me put something K and I'm summing over this index. So if I sum over this index, when will this be non-zero? Abhishek. Abhishek?
Sir, please.
Kya Abhishek?
Sir, ek baar dobara suppose sir, network problem thi thodi.
Network problem hai? Acha. Pritam?
When x and y are not equal to k.
हाँ तो फॉर विच वैल्यूज ऑफ के विल दिस बी नॉन जीरो
जेड फॉर ओनली जेड
ओनली फॉर जेड राइट and this will be equal to 1 right acha and there is no 1 by 2 we factor in here sorry theek hai so now maybe you all know why I am not putting these lectures on youtube because well I don't think you want the whole world to see me asking all these questions like this hai na It's like a proper class session. Okay, so I'll stop over here now. And see, please go back. And I've also not shared my notes with you. I'll share my notes with you just now for the past several lectures. But please, you have to read on your own. You have to work these things out. And I know that there are network problems. Many people have network problems. I can't do anything about that, you know. But even if you are here in class, even if you are physically present, but there are problems then also, na? How many people will show up for class in when you are here? All of you, maybe, maybe not. And when you are in class, can everybody hear what the teacher says? Not necessarily, na? Right? So there are network problems in real world also, na? Okay, then that being said, if any of you have any difficulty, you are free, please contact me directly and ask me for any clarification. Okay, aap samajh rahe hain ye baat? Sabko clear hai ye baat?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Haan? Please, yes, aap mujhse sampark kariye aur mujhe apni kathinaiyan bataiye. Okay. All right, I will stop the recording.